Building CNC part 4. This is a T-slot bed I got off eBay. It's got a 45 by 24 T-slot area, and I'm gonna have to add something over here to collect fluid. So I need to build a basin apparently, or a pair of them, but no, probably just one big one. I'll have to add that into the design. But I didn't know this until I picked it up, but she's actually got rails on it. And they're bolted on. That means I could just take them off, hopefully, possibly, and get them resurfaced if they need it. They probably don't. But yeah, basically that means I could actually use that as an additional manual access to move a part around. That's really good news. So that is the 3/16 thick, really heavy stuff. 2x2, that'll be the structure of the CNC. They are 20 feet long. That might be the shortest that that Boyd Metal sells, I'm not sure. But I needed 60 feet or 55 feet, so he just sold me a set of 320s. So had to put the rack back on my pickup truck and two and a half hour drive there and 2.5 hours back. And that's pretty much it. Just another thing to know if you're gonna build one of these things, if you wanna save the money, like doing something like this, you've gotta be able to haul the steel. Otherwise, you can end up buying little short pieces and it's going to cost you twice the amount. Also, to haul a T-slot bed like that, I don't think I'd even do it in a 1500. Maybe it could be done, but the Ram 2500 handles it just fine. And I guess in the next few days, I'll make a few videos on putting this thing together. Mic out.